Welcome to the beauty and biodiversity at the gardens of Dublin Castle. Let's take a stroll through the flowers and the wildlife found in the gardens of Dublin Castle, within the busy capital city of Ireland, just behind an 800-year-old tower and a neo-Gothic revival chapel. We find an entrance through a stone wall to a peaceful garden arranged around a perfect circle of grass. We are immediately surrounded by a frame of different shades of green, dotted with vibrant colours. We hear the water features and the breeze blowing through the leaves. Facing south from the castle, the garden is a sun trap, attracting those nearby on their lunch break. The serpent-like patterns on the grass denote the site of the Dove Linn, which translates into English as the Black Pool, a body of water formed by the Liffey and the Poddle, which was once found here. This is where the city of Dublin gets its name today. Whether you're listening to this in the gardens or from anywhere around the world, our imagination is needed when describing these organic surroundings, because unlike the castle behind us, the plants and animals here are ever-changing. In the springtime, something that stands out in the beds around the circle is the garden tulip, found in different colours, shapes and sizes. If we turn left, we can walk behind the shrubs into a more private, walled Garda Memorial Garden, which honours those who were killed in service. The sombre tone is reflected in the darker tulips standing to attention. Around them we see geraniums, hydrangeas, fuchsias, the Fichtinia red robin plant, and quite often we see a red robin bird dropping by as well. A small pool of water in the corner alongside beds of soil and earthworms often attracts the robins and other birds to this spot. Robins are widespread across Irish gardens and sometimes like to nest in hats found in garden sheds. As we walk on, filtering out the hum of the city, we hear a buzzing sound. This corner of the garden includes fuzzy purple lilac flowers, which are a favourite for the busy bees of Dublin. They crawl with yellow legs in great numbers over these flowers before taking flight to discover other varieties. Many bee species in Ireland are threatened with extinction, but if we watch one land on a flower, we have a wonderful chance to take a closer look at these important species. We look for the colour of their tail. A warm ginger coloured tail might be the common carder bee. A clean white tail paired with a lemon yellow stripe below the head might be the white-tailed bumblebee. As our eyes follow a bee taking flight, we see a tall and vibrant, striking purple flower in the beds. This is an allium, better known to us as a variety of onion. Onion varieties are not only used for food, but they can produce beautiful, tall, spherical tops of star-like flowers. Some are perennial, which means they flower year after year. Next to it, we find garlic, a beautiful plant which might bring some comfort to those who know that the author of Dracula once worked in this castle. Besides its mythical vampire repellent powers, garlic is also said to be magic by those who grow it today. It can be easily grown year-round in Ireland by simply planting a single clove in the soil. In these beds, leading us around the curve of the garden, we see so many herbaceous plants and flowers, such as royal bumbles, hydrangeas, bees' sunset flowers, and heartleaf plants, guiding our eyes to a shaded corner known as the Snake Garden. We've reached the south, and beside the 19th century coach house, which is framed by trees on either side, these yews, laurels and cherry trees provide shelter, shade, habitat, improved soil and air quality. If we sit on a bench underneath the cherry tree, we can admire the emerald colours, baby charm plants, ferns, Juneberry, and a small water feature with a spiraled sculpture of a snake. The garden birds bathe here quite often, the wren, the thrush, the great tit and the blue tit. are noted visitors of the castle gardens. As more bird species are being threatened with extinction in Ireland, we come to appreciate their songs more than ever, which can be slow and mellow, or sprightly and cheerful. Here the birds can enjoy a sense of privacy with the newly planted hedge of yew trees. Although these trees are only young, the yew is one of the oldest native trees found in Ireland, reminding us of our ancient history. Dublin Castle has been here for 800 years, but yew trees have dominated some fertile soils of Ireland for 8,000 years. Beyond the yew hedge, we see the circle of grass. It is visited by some pigeons walking along the 6 interlocking narrow brick pathways through the grass. Though these trails are not big enough for us, to the pigeons they're like small footpaths through an urban field. The smaller grey birds are feral pigeons, which were once domesticated but are now found in the wild. They're almost identical to their ancestors, the wild rock doves found in the west of Ireland. Other feral pigeons stand out as pure white, black or brown. The larger, plumper grey birds are wood pigeons, the largest variety of pigeon found in Ireland. We stroll along the south path of the garden, past the coach house towards the Chester Beatty Library. In the beds here we see hydrangeas, foam flowers, iron butterflies, six-hill giants, true sour grapes, garden view scarlet, Dart's Gold, Scarlet Bottle Brush, and the Seven Sun Flower. The white foam flowers blowing in the wind remind us of the clash of the waves upon the nearby Irish Sea. Our close proximity to the sea is apparent with the call of the seagulls flying above us and perched on the rooftops all year round. The herring gulls are easily identified by their grey wings and black tails with white spots. If you pass closely by the herring gulls, you will notice their large size, which towers over a smaller common gull. Dublin has the biggest colony of herring gulls in Ireland, with over 1,000 nests at Lambay Island. As we walk on, the sound of the gulls become drowned out by the sound of a water fountain ahead. We walk past the corkscrew hazel tree to find where the trickling sound is coming from. Looking at the twisted, contorted branches above us, we can see why this variant of our native hazel tree gets the corkscrew name. Beyond it is a small garden with a fountain to celebrate the Special Olympics of 2003, which took place in Ireland. The names of all the individuals and families who volunteered to make this event possible are written here. In the soil, we might see beauty berry profusions, burning bush plants, black stockings, chocolate cherry, bright eyes, blue fortune, sage, feather grass, tufted hair grass, and perhaps some small birds darting past us to hide and nest around the hedges. A unique cigar-like tree trunk catches our eye here, the paperback maple. The beautiful chestnut brown bark on the trunk looks like it's peeling off in thin layers. It matches the brick walls of the Chester Beatty Library beyond it. Rather than going inside the library to see their collection of beautiful art, we're continuing our curved walk around the garden toward the bleeding hearts of Dublin Castle. This sounds like a metaphor for dark periods of the castle's history, but this is actually the name given to the beautifully delicate pink flowers that drape little hearts next to the border walls. We also find Bainbury brunettes, which attract butterflies. Although the greatest varieties of butterflies are seen in the burren, the bogs, and nature reserves, Dublin is home to peacock butterflies, small tortoiseshell butterflies, painted ladies, orange tips, holly blues, small white and large white butterflies. The best time to identify a butterfly is when they rest upon a surface. If they rest with their wings out horizontally, they are actually more likely to be a brightly coloured moth. If they rest with their wings folded upright, they are most likely a butterfly which can be identified by colour, shape, and size. Our eyes follow the moving creatures and swaying leaves back to where we first entered the gardens. Here there's a spot we have yet to explore, underneath a canopy of trees and a footbridge connecting the castle to the gardens. Hidden away from the world, we see a wealth of variety of trees, shrubs, and flowers. If we look very closely, we might see a ladybird, which can be a helpful member of this little ecosystem. There are about 5,000 species of ladybirds around the world, but here in Ireland, we have recorded 19 different species, with different numbers of spots. If we look very closely, we might be able to count the spots and find out more about this tiny predator. Each seven-spotted ladybird is said to eat 5,000 smaller insects in just a year. They live in forests, grasslands, suburbs, and here in the city. This shaded corner of the garden includes a sculpture to commemorate the life of the Sunday Independent journalist Veronica Guerin. It tells us, "Be not afraid." We look around further and see reminders of all seasons. The holly has withstood the snow of winter. The little flowers of the Caria, radiating yellow petals, reminds us of the summer sun. Caria plants are a favourite treat for rabbits to eat. Rabbits are known as princes, with 1,000 enemies, and one of those enemies has been noted in the garden. Red foxes are the most widespread carnivore in the world. They adapt to many different environments, including Dublin City, where they are sure to trot around the streets long after the sun sets tonight. As we take one last look around the trees, we see a Virginia creeper wrapped tightly in a spiral around a cherry tree. It's hard to tell where one plant ends and the other begins. It's hard to tell as we walk away where the peaceful garden ends and the rush of the city begins. This urban garden has such a wide variety of plants, animals, and visitors that it allows us not only to appreciate nature, but to appreciate that we are part of nature and have a role to play like all the other living species found here. Beauty in Biodiversity was written by Evelyn Suttle and read by Laura Fitzzachary, who work with the OPW at Dublin Castle. We hope that you've enjoyed this stroll through the Dublin Gardens and that you will join us again for other adventures.